there's a lot of different ways that in my spirit I feel led to go tonight, so we're just going to work it by faith because I don't have direct direction here. Next month, October, is prayer month for me because that's where my little Bible study leads me to. One of the four that I partake of, and when we, in prayer tonight, there was just some things there that I want to mention this one thing. It's just been on my heart, so I want to say it. We were at another church, and there was a particular individual in that church that for probably 2 years prior to us being introduced to him, had suffered immensely. I mean, the guy was cut open. He wouldn't heal. They'd done everything that they could. His body just would not heal, wouldn't accept healing. And he was constantly having to go back to the VA and operate on him again and try to close him back up. He bust back open again. And just a horrible situation. And we became introduced to him and his wife. And I was asked to speak there one night because the pastor was having some difficulties. And he asked me if I would speak for him that night. And the message that I had nothing to do with healing per se. But the Lord spoke to me during that message and directed me to do something. Now, I'm not real big on fasting, as you can tell. But there's a very distinct place that fasting has in prayer.
Absolutely.
And when the Lord directs you, some people can't fast from food. Diabetics, my wife should not miss a meal. In fact, she should have more little meals. And she does a pretty good job of staying true to that. And be alone with it. But what the Lord directed me to in that situation was ask for 5 people, and this was fairly large church, so it wasn't just a small church, but just 5 people that really felt committed to prayer, to fast that week, not necessarily from food, but to spend that particular day, and we would assign the days, once they volunteered, and on those days, just to spend that day prayer concerning this one individual. And not just praying about every carefree thing that we think about, but concentrate on that one individual. Every time they thought of it during the day, they were to bring up this individual's name to the Lord and fast. From if it was food, fasting is this. Fasting in the Bible is anything that keeps you from God. In other words, anything that's interfering with your communication to God, your closeness to God, your intimacy with God. And it can be anything. Listen, it could be the Sunday,
television,
football game, or it could be most anything. And it's not necessarily food, but in one particular case, God dealt with me. Yes, I fasted from food. In fact, I fasted from everything that day. I did nothing but take my Bible up into a little upper room that I had out my workshop, and I stayed there all day, and I just prayed to God. I read scripture and stayed away from everything. I didn't even want, told my wife where I'd be, just don't bother me. I just forget I'm even here. Unless the house burns down, give me a yell, and I'll go ahead and come out. Because I was a fire chief, that's why. But in this particular situation with this individual, whenever I gave that call for 5 people, I'd be very honest with you, I didn't think anybody was going to come up.
That's right.
I even volunteer. I waited for the longest, and finally this one stood up, and finally this one stood up, and I'm counting, Lord, that's only 2. Surely there's 3 more in here that would take the call. But we finally got 5 people. I think there was 2 men and 3 women.
Always.
And,
I said always.
Always, yeah, okay. And they, I instructed them as just how the Lord had directed me, as I've told you here. And they each took a day so that I would know a day. And my part of this was, after I got off work every day, I was going straight to the VA hospital, share some word with him, and pray for him there. And we did that. And after that week was over, he came out of the hospital all right. We were all praising God for that. And then he had a tremendous relapse. It's like Satan does.
Oh, yes.
And to try to defeat people and think, you know, you didn't do so good, you know. That was a shoddy thing to do. I give him some kind of hope, and now look at him. He's in worse shape than he was. He went back, and he went through a terrific extra round. I even went up one day from work when he was having his surgery. And I shared with him before, because me and another music pastor from the church was there that day. And he asked me to pray, and I said, sure, I'll pray for him. And I told him, I said, Fred, I don't care what it looks like. I don't care how it feels. I don't care what you've been through. It's going to work this time. It's going to work. Well, if you knew him today, now he does have to carry a...
No, he had prostate surgery and all that stuff.
He's totally not only that, he works out now. And yeah. He's, you know, up in his 70s, but he goes and works out. And as a result, they didn't stay at that church, but they stayed with God. They're going to another church, but they stayed with God. But what I wanted to share with you through that, there's a time and place, some things, as Jesus said in here,
come out only.
Sometimes it's just, you need fasting and prayer to get this thing done. And so if God puts that upon your spirit, jump at it and listen to your spirit and do what God says. I wouldn't go rushing into a 40-day fast unless God told me
to. That's right.
don't do that because somebody told you that was a necessary thing. Don't do those kind of things unless God tells you to do it. And he may do it, but he hasn't told me yet. Thank you, Jesus. it's a very serious thing. But there is a place for fasting and prayer.
Absolutely.
There's lots of different kinds of prayers in the Bible.
Absolutely.
Chock full of them. And all of them are for our instruction and our example to let us know how to handle things. So that's what I got to share.
And isn't that good?